charges read out in court were true. Prosecutors first pointed to an incident when the accused punched and injured Yota about 1 month before Yota's death. They say the accused was infuriated when a group of Ryota's friends came to his house 7 days before the killing. They say the accused was mad because Ryota apparently told his friends about the previous incident. The prosecutor said the accused asked Ryota to come to the river on the day of the killing. They say the accused killed Ryota because he thought if he didn't, he would either be arrested for injuring him or there would be retaliation. Responding to a question by the defense, the 19-year-old and a boy with him took out a box cutter
and then
used it just to scare Ryota. He says he was carried away by the atmosphere at the time and thought he could be bold.
We can't help it that
he and two other boys repeatedly slashed Ryota.
ファンデーションは嫌だよ。女性用でしょ。
女性の UV クリームっていうのじゃない感じある。混ざってるような感じがするよね。
Questions are being raised as to how the school responded to this problem. The boy in this case had been absent from school for more than a month before the incident.His classroom teacher was the only one who intervened. Others at the school
were not
aware of the trouble the boy was in. The education ministry has been sending social workers to schools to support students in trouble and their teachers. Education Minister Hiroshi Hase says.It's essential to spot warning signs and act on problems before they become serious.
この人プロレスラーだったんやろ？
うん。
プロだったの？この人。
プロレスラーや。
プロレスラーが大事やらなれる
んやね。もうプロフィール。
The Japanese government is aiming to increase food exports to 1 trillion yen by 2020.Aomori apples are on sale at a supermarket in Vietnam. This restaurant in London specializes in Japanese Wagyu beef. Sake from Fukushima was featured at the Davos conference last month. Politicians and business leaders from around the world gathered there to discuss the world economy.Japanese food exports are expanding globally. The Agriculture, Forestry and Fisheries Ministry today announced the country's food exports reached 745.2 billion yen in 2015, up about 20% from the previous year. The figure hit a record high for the third straight year.The popularity of Japanese food and a weaker yen are behind the rise. Agriculture, Forestry and Fisheries Minister Hiroshi Moriyama says the government and non-government sectors will work together to expand food exports. He says the government wants to achieve its 1 trillion yen export target earlier than the current plan.The government set the 1 trillion yen annual target, but there are several challenges. One is halal certification. Food products exported to Muslim countries must be prepared according to Islamic law, and certificates are required. Japanese food producers need to do more to respond to the needs of overseas markets. 38 countries and territories still restrict imports of food from Japan following the Fukushima nuclear accident in 2011.The ministry has called on those countries and territories to lift import bans so that Japan can resume exports as soon as possible.
Prime Minister Shinzo Abe has apologized over the resignation of former Economic Revitalization Minister Akira Amari. He expressed his intention to fulfill his public duty by bringing the country solidly out of deflation. Question and answer sessions were held in plenary sessions of both chambers of the Diet today. Abe's successor, Nobuteru Ishihara, spoke at the start of the lower house plenary session. He says he will make an all-out effort to further ensure that the favorable cycle of the Abenomics economic policy becomes a reality. He says he will do so by erasing concerns about Japan's future, and he will also create an environment so that consumption by all classes of society and corporate investment, including by smaller businesses, takes place in all corners of the country. Vice Chairman of the Democratic Party's Diet Affairs Committee, Chinami Nishimura, asks Prime Minister Shinzo Abe whether the scandal over Amari's funds can be resolved just by Amari giving up his ministerial post. She says Amari has a duty to explain himself, and running away is unforgivable. Abe responds that as Prime Minister, he's responsible for appointing cabinet members. He says he deeply apologizes to the public for the developments in which a cabinet minister whom he appointed had to be replaced. Abe says economic recovery remains the most significant task for his cabinet. He says he intends to solidly fulfill his duty to the public by promoting his Abenomics policies, which are now at a crucial point, and ensuring that Japan rise out of deflation. He says he's determined to be even more serious in his administrative management. Abe was also pressed about appointing Ishihara, who remarked that in the end, it's all about money. He made the comment when, as environment minister, he was addressing the issue of intermediate storage facilities in Fukushima Prefecture. Abe explained that Ishihara has held key LDP posts, such as Secretary General and Policy Research Chief, and has vast experience in ministerial posts. So he says he believes he's appointed a suitable person. The gist of the fiscal 2016 budget bill was explained in the budget committees of both chambers. Finance Minister Taro Aso sought cooperation for early enactment of the bill. The executives of the lower house budget committee then convened. Members of the ruling and opposition camps agreed to request the attendance of Abe and all cabinet ministers from tomorrow through Friday to debate the budget bill.
Our next story is about a lawsuit filed by a railway company following an accident involving an elderly man with dementia. It's demanding compensation for costs that resulted from a stoppage of train services. The first proceeding was held today at the Supreme Court. The ruling is due on March the 1st. The obligation of the man's family to supervise him has become the focus of contention. Families with elderly members suffering from senile dementia are calling for a court decision that takes into account the difficulties they are facing. In 2007, a 91-year-old man was hit and killed by a train at a JR station in Ogu City, Aichi Prefecture. The man suffered from dementia.